organizations really ours? And if they're not, what must we do to make black organizations truly ours and black leaders free enough to lead us? Because if the leaders are not free, they certainly cannot lead you to liberation. And I respectfully suggest that no black leader today that has national prominence, with the exception of myself, is really free to talk to you like real men and to lead you in a proper direction. None of them are free. Brilliance is not freedom. Eloquence is not freedom. The ability to speak to the hurt of your people without looking over your shoulder, wondering whether the former slave master is approving what you say. That is to be free. And I stand before you tonight, a free black man who has not to worry about what anybody thinks about what I say. This is why Farrakhan has a level of popularity that no other black leader enjoys. It's not because I'm better, it's because I'm freer to speak the truth. And that's exactly what our people need, is more truth. You shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. But if your leaders are afraid to speak the truth, because somebody may pull a plug on them, if our preachers are afraid to preach the truth for fear of downtown putting pressure on them, then these are unfit leaders that must be exposed and pushed aside.